but she wasn't quite the same. They knew her heart was aching. She so often spoke his name. The months rolled on, as time will do, and she sensed her time was near. Joy replaced her loneliness, and death she had no fear. She knew that God would never let death be their last goodbye, for true love is forever and doesn't end because we die. On the morning she left us, she smiled and called his name. The thunder rattled and the rain poured down. Soulmates again they became. That's just such mom and dad. They were wonderful together and nothing without each other. On behalf of my brothers and sisters, I would like to begin by thanking everyone in attendance today. Thank you for being here to pay your respects to our mother and for the friendship and love that you gave her through the years. Mom would be very pleased and honored to see that all of you came to or could make it here today. Your continued support, well wishes, cards, and prayers were so comforting to her in her final months. Bruce couldn't get to the mailbox quick enough every day. Mom was our guiding light. She set the example of what a good wife, mother, and friend should be. She always did her best to be patient with all of her children, and there were six of us, so you can imagine what a feat that was. As much as I would like to think that I was Mom's favorite, I know this truly isn't so. We were all Mom's favorites in one way or another. Mom and Dad also enjoyed 5 grandchildren and 4 great-grandchildren, which they adored. Our mom and dad were the true meaning of soulmates. I can honestly say that I don't have one memory of them ever arguing. And with brothers and sisters like mine, they must have been really good at hiding that. But seriously, they met at the age of 16. They knew immediately that they wanted to spend the rest of their lives together. But Grandma and Grandpa Gaynor made them wait until Mom turned 18. So on September 14, 1950, Mom turned 18. And on September 16, 1950, they were married. What a surprise. That was just the beginning of 62 spectacular years together. They did everything together. Along with making sure all of us were taken care of, Mom was also Dad's secretary. They shared the job of running the bowling alley together for 33 years and just did a marvelous job. Since Dad passed away 11 months ago, Mom has seemed so lonely. Even though we have been there for her, it just wasn't the same. Even the friends coming over, the neighbors, it just wasn't the same. Her soulmate was gone, and life just did not have the same meaning to her anymore. It's hard to say if Mom lost the battle or won the battle. She lost her battle with cancer. However, her reward is eternity with the man she so terribly missed, our dad. I would like to share a story with you. After Dad passed away, Mom would always say, "In the future, when you hear thunder, don't be afraid, don't worry. That's just me and your dad upstairs in the clouds dancing." How true that was. Shortly after Mom passed, it started storming. The thunder, the lightning, the rain roared for hours. This, more than anything, has given me such peace. This, to me, means Dad met her at the gates. And boy, did they party all night long. I wasn't up there, but from what I hear, it really stormed, which is typical for Dad. Trust me when I tell you, we will miss them both. But as I said, I did not expect the peace I now feel in their absence, knowing they're together for eternity. We are so happy for the time we got to spend together. Mom was a caring, loving person, and in our opinion, the best mom in the world. Even though she is gone, her memory will live on in our hearts forever. God bless you, Mom. Your friends and family will miss you forever. closing, we would like to thank Regional Hospice for the care they provided to my mom over the past 4 months. Mom was at peace at the end of her life. One last announcement, we would like to invite all of you to a luncheon at our family home immediately following this mass.
Your mom, with joy and in community, is establishing that same community, I believe, in heaven. You know, she's back with Elmer, she's back with her parents. And we are still, even though they are there and we are here, as I said when Mass started, we pray for her now and we pray for Elmer at this time. Let me assure you, they are praying for you as well. And every time we pray for them, they take the prayers that we offer through them up to Jesus, up to God. He in turn grants us those graces that come through those same prayers. So today, this afternoon, as you have your gathering, continue the joy and that love of community that you already have. Let it grow, let it blossom. And if somebody's not here today, remember to invite them the next time you get together. It's always an invitation. Community doesn't exclude. Community is always a continuous invite to come back into the family. I think that's what Janet wrote down.